Like, face me.
Portava solo due pezzettini, che coprivano da cucino a cucino. Con quei due pezzettini, lei non voleva mostrarsi così.
Honestly,
Saturday there's a huge line at CREATOR. I was like,
yeah, what do you think about those balls?
Good looking balls. Nice. Okay, so I've been having a rough patch and I've been expecting you to give me some words of wisdom.
Hold on, well, let's get into the shit so I can see. It's good. Okay.
That for some internal comfort.
So, like, what's been going on, I guess?
I'm, like, embracing change for the first time, like, headstrong, like, forward, like, trying to do things that I normally never would. Mm-hmm. And then people around me have kind of been taking that as a sign of, like, me not being my true self, me being fake, or something along those lines. Because they have given me an image kind of like expecting me to withhold that image, and it's just been stressful, so I had to get out basically.
Yeah, so you feel like you're kind of pretending and you're kind of masking who you really are just to please other people.
Yeah, and so and when I finally like let down my mask, like somebody said this to me and it like really like touched me. Mm-hmm. Like it hurt me basically.
Yeah.
They had invited me out on a trip, right? And I was just like not really down for the trip because I only want to do things that make me really happy. So I don't want to surround myself with people that make me uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. So like when they were trying to give me reasons to convince me to join them, one of the main reasons was that they felt like I would add more to their fun. And so the way that they like worded that kind of just like struck me. I was just like, so you want me to come so that you guys can have more fun? Like,
but what's in it for me?
What's in it for me then? Like,
and so, are these people that like you feel comfortable around really?
Yeah,
like,
I'm comfortable around them, but it's just that sometimes they kind of like give me a sense of like stepping over their boundaries. Like, I felt like I've given people too much control over like my feelings.
I see. So it's more in the sense that they don't respect your boundaries when you actually assert them, rather than...
And people think that when you assert your boundaries, you're just trying to distance yourself, but sometimes asserting boundaries is just to get closer in a way.
Yeah, because it's very important for any form of connection to have healthy boundaries, because that way that's something that can actually be built to last. It's going to be on a strong foundation. Yeah, it really pains me that like people don't understand that sometimes saying no is really critical, really important.
Or like people don't like to accept your answer for your answer, just like at face value.
Yeah.
Sometimes people will say like, why do we need an explanation for the things you do? And I feel like I just don't need to explain like why I do certain things.
Yeah, and seeing it from like both perspectives. Because like for them, they might be like, oh, maybe she doesn't like us as a friend anymore. But what in them is triggering that kind of response, you know? Mm-hmm. Because they don't know what's going on for you. Like for you, you might just be feeling, as you said, mentally drained. Mm-hmm. You might need that break. That's not necessarily a bad thing to do or like a bad thing to take for yourself.
And I've been kind of like, for me personally, been just embracing not looking happy all the time. So I feel like I've made that into my default, and so it's kind of hard to switch back to just having natural reactions, facial expressions, things like that.
Yeah, because you don't have to be happy all the time. things happen, and it's like that's a part of like really loving yourself too, is accepting yourself at every dimension and every depth of feeling that you do have.
I love nap time.
Not Cherie time.
For the first time.
For the first time in a long time. How long has it been?
I'd say COVID. In terms of deep in person.
True. Because we've seen each other like what, once or twice, but
yeah. It's kind of become like a biannual
tradition. I missed her. I'm glad like you could be real with me though.
Yeah, I feel like I can really just tell you things like and not expect you to like add fuel to the fire.
Yeah, that's like a skill I've been like trying to like develop in myself too, is like the ability to like really listen, because yeah, I guess like when you expect a sort of outcome or you try to kind of have things go your way, you don't leave enough space for like the other person to just be. And I've had like that happen to me in like past relationships. It just kind of opened my eyes to how much like on what I can like work on in myself as well. And I'm like,
and then like on that note, like I admire you in that aspect, and I feel like you've kind of triggered the journey of me trying to find my own personal philosophy. Cause I feel like I've been like treading through life without like a certain faith in anything. You know how people, some people that have religion put their faith into like God, but like what about the non-believers? You have to find faith in other things.
Yeah, and like for me, I don't know how it is for you personally, but for me, I always believe that there is, like, something higher. I don't subscribe to any religion, but for me, it's most, like, I always make time to just be with myself and with the Most High, just connect with whatever else is out there, whatever's guiding me, because I firmly believe that, you know, there is something out there that's greater than just me, because in a way, we're all one, and we're all a part of that thing, but what it is, I don't know. And I've accepted, it's like my limited human mind can't fully comprehend that. People try to explain that in different ways, and like that's kind of the way I see religion. It's more like a way to explain and connect with that higher being while having a more mental understanding of it. But I don't think spirituality can be understood on the level of the mind.
Yeah, exactly.
That's why it's so important to connect with your body and with your feelings, because I feel like that's the closest way we can get to that infinite. Mm-hmm.
And on that note, I'm glad that talked about this before. We've had multiple conversations about this.
We've had. Well, anyway, that was deep.
That was deep.
Let's go to Whole Foods.
Onwards.
Pastrano e finalmente avanzò verso il mar. Era un costume. They see her rolling. They hate it. Patrolling, trying to catch it right.
So funny, I didn't do this today. All my teeth fell out.
Oh, I actually had that. Like,
and then I woke up touching my mouth, trying to feel my hair. Like, you know what those dreams
mean, that you feel like you're not controlling your life and that things are falling apart, or it's like a sign of big change. I've read that online. Like, I don't know how accurate that is, but.
Yeah, because I was like,
like,
it felt so real.
My dreams are like hella whack though.
Yeah, I can imagine. I can totally imagine.
I don't think I can have those battles.
Ree discovers kombucha.
Sacred life is what I need.
Sacred life.
9 billion living probiotics. Wow. Okay. I need some sacred life.
Maybe a bit of watermelon wonder.
I'm actually kind of a trilogy girl.
I'm a trilogy girl. I'm a sacred life girl. Take your probiotics.
Yeah. Gut health is important, guys.
Yeah.
Gut health and mental health actually goes very hand in hand. Oh, whoa. Maybe I should go for a strawberry serenity.
I'm gonna try that.
That sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
funny.
Oh my god. Wait, you gotta zoom in on the bananas with my pocket.
Oh wow.
Oh, watch it.
Not filming. Oh my god. Oh my god. Look at her go. Cherie, this is fucking hilarious.
My suitcase.
Ma'am, I like your bouquet.
Oh, thank you. Gotta stuff the other, here, drop the bananas.
Drop the bananas.
Into this side pocket. There we go.
Oh my god.
Okay. What? We're good.
Crisis averted.
Gotta catch that bus.
Gotta catch your bus. Look at her go. Why are you running? Run, Cherie, run. You gotta catch your bus. Beautiful, sure in New York, but you have no lighting on your face. Oh my gosh.
Poi finalmente si spoglie su questa, ma tutti quanti la stanno a guardare. Non hai coraggio di uscir poveretta. Non hai coraggio di uscire dal mar.
Sending love.
Oh my god. E rompi la scrittura.